Hello friends, this is BK Kollapure. Earlier we had seen what are thin cylinders. Today we will go further for what we will see as thick cylinders. We had seen that in case of thin cylinder, the thickness is less than 1/10 to 1/15 of radius. So when you go to thick, thickness will be definitely greater than 1/10 of the radius. In case of thin cylinder, whatever radial pressure, the pressure, internal pressure that is acting, radial pressure is neglected. Whereas in case of thick cylinder, if you see the thickness of the cylinder, if this is a complete cylinder, this is a thickness, it is observed that this is the inner thickness and this is outer layer. So you see that the hoop radial pressure is maximum on the inner face, and as you go outside it become zero. So you find that the radial pressure is maximum on the inner thickness and it will be minimum or zero on the outer thickness. Now the third condition is hoop stress, what we have seen in thin cylinder. Suppose if I take the thickness, this is the thin cylinder what we have seen. In case of thin cylinder, if I draw the hoop stress, it remains uniform across the thickness. But in case of thick cylinder, if the thickness is more, you observe that on the inner face, the hoop stress is maximum, and as you go outside, the hoop stress is minimum. So if I join these two, it is observed that hoop stress is maximum on inner surface and hoop stress is minimum on the outer surface. So these are some of the assumptions what we do, and the examples you can quote here for is tires, gas pipes, then water tank. These are some of the example. Whereas here thickness is heavy. When we use thickness heavy, definitely the pressure will be very high. So here you can give an example of gun barrel, high pressure valves, these are some of the examples of the thick cylinder. Now here, in case of thick cylinder, we come across a very important theorem, what we known as Lamy's theorem. It is known as Lamy's theorem. Lamy's theorem gives the variation, if we have seen just now in the thickness, variation of the radial pressure on inner face to the radial pressure on the outer face, and also it will give what is the maximum hoop stress on the inner face and what is the minimum hoop stress on the outer face. So for this, a formula has been given by Lamy's theorem, which will be provided to you in your group. But we will see here the formulas that he has given. For one is radial pressure, which we denote it as P, and if I call it as X, he has given the formula Px is equal to V by X square minus A, where A and B are the constants and X is the distance of the radius from the center. If we go on changing the distances, inner radius, outer radius, so this gives the variation. X is the distance from the center, inner face to outer face. He has also given another formula for hoop stress. It says that hoop stress at any distance x from the center is given by V by X square plus A. Now this is an equation for radial pressure and this is the equation for the hoop stress. So this is B by X square minus A and this is equal to B by X square plus A. That's the only difference between radial pressure and hoop stress. And this A and B are constant in both the cases, and X is the distance of the face from the center of the pipe. So using these two equations, we will be solving or drawing the radial pressure diagram and the hoop pressure diagram. Let us see some example here. So you will have to go through this derivation of the formula by using Lamy's theorem. Now suppose, if you consider a thick pipe, this is a very thick pipe. So this is the inner radius and this is the outer radius. Suppose the inner radius is say 300 mm and the outer radius is 450 mm. So inner radius is 300 mm, outer radius is 400 and let me take it as 425 mm. Now you are required to find out the hoop stress on the inner face and the outer face. Suppose this is subjected to a pressure of 11.2 newton per mm square. This is on the inner face because pressure is maximum on the inner face, and pressure will go on reducing as you go to the external face. It will become zero. If there is any external pressure acting, that will be the minimum pressure acting on the outer face. So here radius on inner side, that means on inner side when R is equal to 300 mm, the pressure is 11.2 newton per mm square. On the outer face, the pressure is zero. That means when X is equal to 425 mm, the pressure on the outer surface will be zero. You need to find out always in thick cylinders two things. One is A and B, the constants, Lamy's constants. To find out two constants, you need two equations. So you will be using these two equations to find out the value of A and B. Once you know A and B, you can determine the hoop stress at any point. Now to do that, so the data what is given is inner radius, outer radius and the inner pressure. Indirectly the outer pressure will be zero. You are required to find out the hoop stress on the maximum, that is on inner face, and hoop stress on the outer face, that is the minimum. And you'll have to draw the radial pressure diagram, that is P diagram, and you'll have to draw the hoop stress diagram, that is the diagram for the sigma value. So now let's try to find out the value of A and B, then go for the solution. So we know that radial pressure P x at any distance x is given by the formula B by x square minus A. So when x is equal to inner face, so this inner face radius is 300 mm and this outer radius is 425 mm. So when x is equal to 300 mm, Px will be equal to what is maximum pressure acting on inner face? 11.2 newton per mm square. So if I substitute the values here, 11.2 is equal to B by 300 square minus A. Let us call this 1. Similarly, when on outer face means radius will be when R is equal to 425 mm, the radial pressure will be zero. It is maximum on inner face to zero on the outer face. So if I use this relation, zero, P will be zero, is equal to B by 425 square minus A. This is second equation. So you have got two equations, two unknowns. If you solve for A and B, so you will get here A is equal to 11.2. A is equal to 11.2 and B is equal to 2009048. This will be the value of B. Once you find out A and B, you can solve for hoop stress. So if I go for the calculation of hoop stress, we'll use this condition. We know the formula given by Lamy for hoop stress. Sigma x is equal to B by x square plus A, or this will be equal to B is 2009048 divided by x square plus A is 11.2. We have got this general equation. Now we will find out what is hoop stress on inner face when x is equal to 300, and we will find out hoop stress on the outer face when x is equal to 425 mm. So let us write here, when x is equal to 300 mm, hoop stress is maximum on inner face. So this will be equal to 2009048 divided by inner face is 300 square plus 11.2. When you calculate, you get the maximum hoop stress is given by 33.44 newton per mm square, and when x is equal to 425 mm, hoop stress is minimum on the outer face. This will be equal to 2009048 divided by outer face radius is 425 square plus 11.2, and this will be the minimum hoop stress, which is given by 22.24 newton per mm square. Now we came to know what is the inner radial pressure, which is already given to you. We know the external radial pressure is zero. We knew the maximum hoop stress. We know the minimum hoop stress. Using these values, let us try to plot the hoop stress diagram and the radial pressure diagram along the thickness of the cylinder. Suppose if I take this as the thickness of the cylinder, this is the center, this inner radius is 300 mm, this external radius is 425 mm. If I consider an axis, if I draw radial pressure is maximum here and it is zero on the outer face. So you'll have to join these two points. These two points are joined by a parabola. So these are the ordinates, and we have got the maximum pressure is 11.2 newton per mm square. And here on the outer face, the radial pressure is zero. So this diagram is radial pressure diagram. Now we'll come for the hoop stress diagram. If I see to the hoop stress diagram, maximum here, sigma max is given by 33.44 newton per mm square, and minimum stress is on the outer face. This is given by 22.24 newton per mm square. You'll have to join these two points again by a parabola. Now this diagram, what we have drawn, we call it as hoop stress diagram. This is radial pressure diagram and this is a hoop stress diagram. At any point, you will come to know how much is the radial pressure acting and how much is the hoop stress acting. That is the distance x. At any distance x from the center, you can locate the radial pressure and the hoop stress. It's a very simple problem which is usually asked. So important thing is to draw the hoop stress diagram and the radial pressure diagram. Let's come to the next category of problem. In this problem, internal pressure is given, external pressure is known to you. So you are located maximum hoop stress and minimum hoop stress. Let us see the other category of problem. Again, there is a thick cylinder. The inner diameter is 100 mm. You should find out what is the external diameter. You'll have to find out external diameter. It is subjected to a radial pressure of P is equal to 50 newton per mm square. He has given you the inner pressure, which is equal to 50 newton per mm square. The second condition what he has given is, you should find out the thickness of this thick cylinder such that the maximum hoop stress is 150 newton per mm square. Means he has given you sigma max, and this sigma max is 150 newton per mm square. So you know these two datas are necessary to find out two constants A and B. So using these relations, you can find out the external radius. Twice the external radius will give the external diameter. So here he has given internal diameter, he has given you the inner pressure, he has given you the maximum hoop stress that is acting. So knowing this, you will have to find out, you can find out the thickness also. So this thickness plus the internal diameter will give the external diameter of the thick cylinder. So we'll go on with the solution of this. So here he has given the internal diameter as 100 mm. We need the radius because we measured the distance from the center. So we need the radius. So here R, if I call it as, is 50 mm. When R is 50 mm, that is the inner pressure is maximum. So the condition what we will be using is Px is equal to 50 newton per mm square. We also know that maximum hoop stress is on the inner face, means when R is equal to 50, sigma max is equal to 150 newton per mm square. Now let us see what is the Lamy's theorem. Lamy's theorem says that maximum pressure Px is given by B by x square minus A, and the maximum hoop stress sigma max is given by, or sigma x at any distance x is given by B by x square plus A. Let us use the condition when R is equal to 50 mm. When R is equal to 50 mm, Px is equal to maximum radial pressure is 50 newton per mm square. If I substitute this value in this equation, 50 is equal to B by 50 square minus A. B by 50 square minus A. And when R is equal to, or X is equal to 50 mm, he has given sigma max is equal to 150 newton per mm square. So if I substitute this value in sigma X, so this will be 150 is equal to B by 50 square plus A. So this is our equation 1. This is our equation 2. If you simplify these two equations A and B, or if I add them, minus A plus A gets cancelled. So 50 plus 150 will be 200 is equal to this B by 50 square plus B by 50 square. So it will be 2B by 50 square. If you simplify, you will get the value of A and B. So the value of A, when we simplify, we get A is equal to 50. And the value of B will be equal to 250000. These are the values of A and B. Once you know the value of A and B, then you can find out the minimum hoop stress on the outer face, and you can plot the graph also. So let us find out the external radius, which is the thing what we need to find out. Now, we know that on the external face, when x is equal to, if I call it as capital R, inner is small r, outer is the capital R. When x is equal to R, we know the radial pressure on the outer face is 0. radial pressure on the outer face is 0. Suppose if I use this relation, 0 is equal to, we are using relation for Px, which will be b by x square minus a. So 0 will be b, we know the value 250000 divided by, we don't know the distance, we are required to find out r minus a is 50. If you simplify for this, you get the value of r is equal to 70.71 mm, if you simplify. Then he has asked you what is the thickness of the cylinder. We have got internal, we have got external. We know the internal radius is 50 and the external radius is 70.71. So what will be the thickness of this? Outer radius minus the inner radius. So thickness T will be equal to 70.71 minus 50. So this will be equal to 20.71 mm. So this is another category of problem. Two stresses will be given to you. You will have to find out the thickness, or you will have to draw the hoop stress diagram. This is the second category of problem on thick cylinders. Let us see one more problem on thick cylinder. Now there is a thick cylinder. You know the external diameter. Suppose if I take the external diameter as 500 mm. You know the internal diameter. Suppose if I take it as 400 mm. Now in this, the maximum hoop stress, I'll give you maximum hoop stress, sigma max, in this will be equal to 75 N/mm². 75 N/mm². You are required to find out what is the maximum pressure acting on the inner face. So in last class, pressure was given, hoop stress was given, you are required to find out the thickness. In this case, maximum hoop stress is given, but you are required to find out how much pressure I can apply on the inner face, such that the pressure on the outer side will be equal to 0. So when R is equal to, when X is equal to inner, that is 200 mm, you are required to find out what is the pressure. But on the outer face, when X is equal to D is diameter, half of that will be, when X is equal to 250 mm, P will be equal to 0. So you have got two conditions, one is sigma condition, another is P condition. You will get A and B. So you are required to find out in this problem how much internal pressure I can apply if a thick cylinder of inner diameter 400 mm, external diameter 400 mm, is capable of withstanding a maximum stress of 75 N/mm². So using these data, we will try to find out and also draw the stress distribution diagram. So here, let me take the things clearly. So here, inner diameter is 400 mm. So inner radius will be half of this, 200 mm. External diameter is 500 mm. So the inner radius will be 250 mm. Given when X is equal to outer side means 250 mm, the radial pressure is equal to 0. Let us use this condition. We know Lamy's theorem is given by, for Px it is b by x square minus a, and for sigma x it is given by b by x square plus a. So we are using P equation here. So 0 is equal to b by x will be 250 square minus a. This is one condition. Second condition what he has given is, when x is equal to 250 mm, that is he has given you the maximum permissible pressure or the tensile stress of the material is 75 newton, sigma is equal to 75 newton per mm square. 75 newton per mm square. Suppose if I use this relation, we are going to use this condition, so 75 must be equal to V by, it is on inner face only, 250 square plus A. So this is equation 1, this is equation 2. If you solve equation 1 and 2, you get the value of A is equal to 29.27. It's a constant, and the value of B will be equal to 182968 approximately. 182968. Once I got A and B, then I can find out what are the things required here. So we will find out, we know maximum pressure on the inner face, we will find out what is the minimum pressure on the outer face, hoop stress, and we will also find out what is the maximum pressure on the inner face. Where is the pressure maximum? On inner face. So what he has asked is, when x is equal to 250, then P is equal to B by x square minus A. So if I use this relation, 182968 divided by inner face is 200 mm square, this is 200, sigma is 75 newton per mm square, so this should be 200, because on inner face hoop stress is maximum. So if you simplify, you get these two values. So when x is equal to 250, that is on inner face it should be, so again it should be 200. So on inner face the hoop radial pressure and hoop stress both are maximum. We want to find out on the inner face what is the pressure acting. So B by x square minus A, A is 29.27. if you simplify for P, you get the value of P is equal to 16.46 newton per mm square. So this is the maximum inner pressure that is acting on the inner face, and on the outer face the pressure acting what we have taken is 0. Hoop stress is maximum on the inner face, this is 75 newton, and we will find out what is the minimum hoop stress on the outer face. So for that, the value of x will be changing. So on the outer face means 250, when x is equal to 250, when x is equal to 250 mm, we will find out hoop stress. Hoop will be minimum on the outer face. This is equal to B by x square plus A. So B is here 182968 divided by 250 square plus A is 29.27. You get the minimum hoop stress acting on the inner face is 58.54 newton per mm square. 54.58 newton per mm square. Now you know the inner radial pressure, you know the external radial pressure 0, you know the maximum hoop stress on the inner face, you know the minimum hoop stress on the outer face. Knowing this, you can draw the stress diagram and the pressure diagram across the thickness of the thick cylinder. If you see the diagram, the thickness what I have taken, I will magnify it. So this is our center line, this is our radial pressure diagram, maximum on inner face, 0 on the outer face. Let us join these two by parabola. So here the maximum pressure which is acting is 16.46 newton per mm square, on the outer face it is 0. This diagram is the radial pressure diagram. Let's draw the Hoop stress diagram. Hoop stress is maximum on the inner face, it is minimum on the outer face. Let us join these two points by a parabola. If you see the maximum hoop stress, what is acting on inner face is 75 Newton per mm square, which is given in the problem, and we have calculated the minimum hoop stress acting is 58.54 Newton per mm square. This is the hoop stress diagram. Hoop stress diagram. So these are the only category of problems that will be coming across in thick cylinder. Thank you.